Hey, welcome back to the channel. I finally got my boat back. I'm not lost to sea or something like that. So it's been a long 3 months, and about, you know, due to COVID and shipping and ground and, you know, things like that, it just took a long time to get it fixed. And then also the place I got it fixed was kind of backed up. But I do want to tell you guys a little bit about shipping with the boats. If I had to do it all over again, I would get a more professional company to do it. I got this company called UShip, where basically you get the, you know, these people on there, they bid on, you know, shipping your boat to you. Now, I didn't go with the cheapest guy possible that bid. I went with a guy that got good reviews and things like that. But basically, probably what happened was something come up from the road and scratched the bottom of the boat, right? And so what, you know, I also had a curtain that went missing along the way that cost a few $100s, you know, that covers up my boat toilet and all that area. He said somebody came in probably in the middle of the night and stole it because he didn't lock the door, but I don't know why anybody would want a curtain, but you know, whatever, it's gone. So I bought the curtain, and then I also had to go pay to get the fiberglass fixed and all the cost of that. So it was gonna be over $1,000 for everything. You know, normally if it was a couple $100, I wouldn't worry about it, but I did call the insurance company. I did check on the guy's insurance company that I used, the UShip, and I called, and it was a company out of Baton Rouge, and basically they said, you know, this guy's got insurance and that's all they can tell me. And I was like, okay, well, he's got insurance, everything's good. And so long story short, basically I filed a claim on his insurance, and they told me that the guy lapsed his insurance or canceled it or something like that the day he picked up my boat. So luckily, the boat made it all the way here without any more issues, but it basically came all the way here without any insurance, which is really, really scary. And so I wasn't able to file a claim on his insurance or anything like that because he basically ran it without. And there's really no way to know, you know? I mean, you're just kind of at the mercy of the person telling you he's got insurance. I called, I did my due diligence, and I got his license and all that kind of stuff. You know, I made sure everything was legit. But you know, if I had to do it all over again, I would definitely go with a more legit company. It was going to probably be double the cost, but, you know, it would definitely be worth it now. And, you know, I told the guys what happened at Defiance, and I want to give a big shout out to them because they did make it right. They actually reimbursed me my money, and they didn't have to at all. But they were like, hey man, you know, you got a brand new boat from us, and we just want to make it right, and we just want you to be happy with your purchase and all this kind of stuff. And so, you know, I was kind of stressed out about what all happened and trying to get all that taken care of and all the phone calls and stuff. And those guys just were like, hey, we're just going to take care of it. And they just reimbursed me the money. So big shout out to Bo and Steven and Mark. Those guys have been great. You know, they didn't have to do that, and they just really went out of their way to, you know, make sure everything was taken care of for me, and it was just a real smooth process and easy, you know, not have to deal with a lot of that kind of stuff. So, but you know, you guys be careful if you get your boat shipped. You know, if I had to do it all over again, I would do it in a heartbeat. I love the boat, and I'm glad I got it, and I would definitely get the same exact boat, but I would just, you know, get the more legit shipping company. You know, they, you know, they said that they use this company all the time, you know, so I was like, okay, you know, whatever. And I did check on the insurance, and everything looked good. So just make sure you get some more reputable, in my opinion, than what I went with. UShip does have insurance. They only cover up to a certain amount, so it didn't cover the full cost of the boat. So when the guy said he had insurance, and he sent me all the paperwork, and I verified it and all that, I thought I was good to go. But obviously, I wasn't. So, but just kind of tell you where my ordeal is, and I'm gonna be back to making content again. And if you guys could subscribe, because it really helps open up a lot more things in YouTube and things like that aren't available to me right now. So I got a lot of good stuff coming up. I got some big plans, some pretty interesting plans. I think you guys will like, of course, just getting it on the water, trying out the boat and all that kind of thing, yeah, stuff like that. Please like and subscribe, and tune in to the next episode.